or opportunities for people to come and work. I mean, like I'm really happy to say that a lot of the people like who work in our company were actually people who were working in the US but were looking to come back, and there were not enough opportunities for them to come back because like nobody does core R&D, or you know, kind of very few companies do core R&D kind of work in product development. So the idea was to, you know, like to contribute towards the economy, it's really essential to reverse this brain drain process. So what are these dots? I mean, we always talk about connect the dots in the right way, but I feel the before even you connect them, it's essential to find them. So what are these dots? So the first thing is an inspiration. And I mean, like I think Nilesh would probably know, is that when I was studying at this college, like Nilesh used to sit in one lab and we used to spend like nights discussing on ideas, on like any crazy idea, you know, like something like this can be done, how it can be done, where it can be done, like try something out, search the internet, and you know, kind of you had to find an inspiration. Like great ideas are actually inspired from, and my summary is kind of they get inspired from these kind of things. It can be something that you're doing in everyday life which you think can be done in a more effective way. For example, Facebook evolved as an idea which was being done in everyday life, where this guy thought that it, like how can I keep in touch with the friends like forever. Ideas are inspired from movies, like our idea. Ideas are inspired from research papers. Ideas are inspired from nature. Like a classic example is Qualcomm bought out a company which does MEMS displays. So MEMS basically, like MEMS display uses a technology which uses natural lighting to show things on the LCD in a very, very effective way. I mean, most of the LCDs, they don't work under sunlight. But if you try to mimic nature, you can actually see these displays under sunlight. I mean, why can you see a flower under sunlight? So it's based on a similar type of technology. You know, it's inspired by nature. You know, you can, like, if you read a lot of news or books, you know, you can get an inspiration from there. Inspiration, of course, comes from having coffee with friends or discussing things with friends. And internet, I mean, if you're an avid surfer, you know, you can get ideas from there or inspirations from there. And the thing is that question everything, like don't accept things the way they are, because maybe they are not done in the right way. I mean, CDMA would have never evolved like to improve, say, the spectral efficiency of the spectrum if, say, Dr. Jacobs would have never thought that, you know, like what GSM did was the right thing. I mean, they tried to do something in a very different ways. Same example for iPhone. So question everything, question whether something you see in your daily life or you're experiencing is being done in the right way or not. So the next dot is basically is idea. And I mean, a lot of people are scared about discussing ideas. I feel you shouldn't be scared. If you have an idea, share it with friends, because ideas actually grow by sharing. You get a lot of feedback, and you should learn to sleep over feedbacks. Like a lot of ideas are great when they come, but when you discuss them with friends, see, if you keep an idea to yourself and don't discuss it with anyone, you will probably try to convince yourself that it's a great idea, and you may land in a very difficult situation in future where you realize, oh, I didn't actually look to this kind of an assumption, or probably this assumption was wrong. So learn to sleep over ideas, get feedback from friends, keep on refining the idea. A very good way to validate an idea, and I'm specifically talking from a technology standpoint, is rapidly prototype it. Like try to get a working model of it so that you can show it to people, saying that this is how I'm planning to do it, this is how it works. And a very important thing is learn to unlearn. Like if you have some assumptions, or if there are some things that you have learned over time, you should be able to think at abstraction levels. I mean, like what probably a company like Apple does is that they don't see what's around. They unlearn everything and they try to design something from scratch, from a usability standpoint, from a design standpoint. So learn to think at an abstraction. They say kids are the most creative thinkers. Why? Because their mind is not polluted with information. They can think at some abstraction level. They can think at some abstraction level. That's why they come up with good ideas. They come up with very creative things which probably even you wouldn't have thought of doing. So it's very important to understand that how you work at abstractions. And you know, this KISS principle, like if there is an idea, keep it simple and stupid. Like don't try to work on something very complex which it takes like 2 hours presentation to explain it to someone. You know, an idea should be simple, where you should be able to explain it to someone with less than a minute. So, and the end person should be able to understand the idea in less than a minute, or in the applicability of the idea. And when people say that ideas actually get leaked by sharing, the fact is that they don't get leaked by sharing. In fact, they get improved. And you know, you also kind of learn to criticize them or accept criticism towards them. The next dot, especially if you're trying to start a company, is avoid looking at what the competition is doing, because as I said in the earlier slide, an idea can get polluted if you're not thinking at an abstraction. So if I have an idea, I don't even look at the internet or what patents are out there or nothing. You try to find your own solution towards it. You try to think a solution which you think is right. You try to engineer the problem to a depth good enough that you can convince that this is the way to solve it. And then go out and see on what other people did or what other people tried to do in order to solve that problem. If you just go to the internet and start searching the ideas, you'll find something, oh, this guy's already doing it, forget it. It's not that way. It's not like the way, it's not the idea, it's also the way it is done that matters a lot. Set your own standards in the market. Like, don't look at competition. I mean, for us, the competition is Microsoft, but we are ready to accept it that Microsoft is there in the competitive space. But it's really essential to set your own standards on where you want to go, and collaborate wherever needed. So form partnerships. Like, don't try to do everything yourself. If you require some technologies, sometimes it's cheaper to collaborate with companies.